Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video, we're gonna do a little range time short with the Beretta M9A3. So I'm actually going off to the indoor range to do a little shooting with the Beretta. Now, the Beretta is strictly a range gun only, and I'm sorry about this, the camera angle. This is actually, I can't even see it because I'm driving, but it's mounted funny because I don't have my regular mount that goes on the windshield. So sorry if it's all off and it's bouncing all over the place. But anyways, so I'm heading off to the indoor range to shoot some rounds with my Beretta M9A3. This is a range fun gun only. I don't, you know, carry it or do anything like that. It'll come out if I'm with a group of friends and they may want to shoot like a 9mm. But I haven't taken this thing out in a while, so I figured I'd just throw up some footage for you guys. So I'm gonna go into the indoor range and do a little bit of shooting. All right, here we go. All right, Beretta M9A3. We all know Berettas are very reliable. All right, we're gonna shoot the Beretta M9A3 at this target, which is about 30 feet away. Here we go. Alright, here we go again. Very good. The grip angle reminds me a lot of the 1911. Really does. See how that went to safe when I did it over the top? So that's just something to keep in mind. Very nice. Right, so I just left the range, the indoor range, so hopefully you guys got a kick out of that. Just got a, you know, did a little bit of footage of me shooting that M9A3. Again, that's a fun range gun only. I rarely take it out, and if I do, you know, it's with a group of friends. For the most part, that isn't the first 9mm I take out of the safe to go shooting with, but it is a, you know, a pretty cool 9mm full-size handgun. But again, it's just a range fun gun only. Very easy to shoot, recoil is incredibly manageable. You know what, I don't think I ever did a video about this, but I had sold my other Beretta 92A1, that's the one with the rail, that I sent to Wilson. And I sold that to an individual that just really, really wanted it locally. And I probably lost, I think I lost like 150 bucks on that, so that's not bad at all. But it was, I thought it was a fair sale. So he has it. I sold that a while ago, guys, so I don't think I ever did a video about that. I guess I never did. Oh well. So anyways, yeah, that one was sent to Wilson. They, you know, redid the finish, everything, that, you know, flat dark earth. That was a really cool handgun. But I actually like the M9A3 the best because of that grip angle. That's like a 1911. I don't know, I just like it more. And so this other, like I said, this other guy really wanted my 92A1 that was done up by Wilson, so I sold it to him. I think he still has it. I'm not sure. That guy trades a lot of guns, so he may not have it anymore, because I know another gun I sold to him ended up at Cabela's in the gun library. So whatever. So yeah, I don't have that Beretta 92A1 anymore. Not that was gone. I sold that a long time ago, so I just never did a video. But, you know, Berettas are really cool. Would I ever carry a Beretta? If I had to, I would, but it wouldn't be my first choice because of the DASA. But I do feel that the M9A3 has a really good double action trigger press. It rolls back really nice. It hasn't had any work done on it, so that's pretty cool that it's kind of stock, because it felt very similar to the 92A1 that Wilson, you know, kind of spruced up. So I was thinking about that. I'm like, you know, the trigger presses on both of these are very, very, very similar. So I don't know, take it for what it's worth. Now, if you want to go to the other Berettas that Wilson, the Wilson exclusives, Centurion and the Brigadier Tactical, they kind of have the same trigger press as the M9A3. So I'm just going to leave it out there like that. Well, guys, I guess that's about it. I got to get going. It's getting dark out. So hopefully you enjoyed that little bit of footage of me shooting that Beretta. Like I said, I've kind of hit a wall on showing you guns because I've shown you pretty much everything. I haven't bought a new gun in quite some time. So like I said in my, Happy New Year 2019 video, I've shown you every single gun that I've wanted to show you guys. I haven't purchased anything new in a long time. I don't know. So going forward, I'm thinking up different concepts, like more range footage, possibly. Right now it's winter time, so I don't really go out to a certain outdoor range where I can do more movement and shooting on the move and things like that. But when springtime comes, I'll do some more footage of shooting my carry gun, which continues to be the ultralight carry compact 4-inch barrel 1911, still going 100%. I know a lot of people ask me about that, how it's doing. So I may do an update video next or soon. But there's really not much else to show you guys. People still want me to show or talk about the ARs. The AR pistol that I did a video about kind of exploded for some reason. So there's a lot of positive and there's a lot of negative. I'm getting a ton of emails about my AR pistol. I don't know why, but I may do another video about the AR pistol, but that seems to be incredibly popular for whatever reason. Lots of emails about that, and I can't answer every single email, guys. I just cannot. So we may visit the AR platform again, maybe some revolvers, and I'm sticking to 1911s. That's just how it goes. All right, guys, I gotta get going here. What time is it? Yeah, I gotta get going. So I just want to say I will be taking a long hiatus, so about a month, okay? I just got a lot of stuff going on, 2019, a lot of changes. Again, I don't know how many videos I can really do, consistently. So I just want to throw that out there. But I do want to say thank you to all the hardcore, dedicated, guys that watch my videos and we talk. And you guys know who you are. I'm not going to go through a list of names and things like that. But you guys know who you are. And I just want to say thank you for sticking with me from 2011 till 2019. Some of the guys from the old school, so just things are changing this year, and I don't know how many videos I'm going to be able to push out, I guess, this year. So just throwing it out there, but I am taking a hiatus, guys, for a little bit, about a month, I would say. So I will be back to doing these videos in March, all right? So, hey, stick with me. Hopefully you will, and I'll be back. in about a month. All right, guys, and again, I really appreciate people spending their time with me, watching the videos, posting comments and things like that. It's just really, really cool. It's a good release, like I say, doing videos, and I've met so many really cool people, and yes, I've met some crazy people at the same time. Not a lot, but there are some crazy people out there, and some people were asking me to do videos about the whack jobs out there, and I may do that, so I might have to out some people. But, alright guys, that's it for now. Stick with me. I'll be gone for 1 month. I'll be back in March. Alright guys, as always, stay safe and check 360 often. See you next month.